know, the most anxiety-producing part of trips for me is, like, getting ready for it. Mm. Now that we are, like, on our way, the bags are in the bag.
I packed so much. So
oh, lie. Me too, though.
I had no idea. I have, like, think 7 bathing suits. I'll probably wear one.
Why do you have a book bag?
Because I've got my personal training book in there. I gotta study because I've only got a few more weeks.
A few more weeks before what?
I gotta take my personal training certification, like, test.
You are doing it. See, this is always the way it goes.
I'm taking the test. That don't mean that I'm passing.
Have you met yourself?
Yeah, but also, I mean, it's not like I haven't had all the time in the world to do this. I have, but I haven't done it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I still feel like I'm on a crash course. I purposefully chose the most highly regarded personal training certification that there is because I know that people are going to look at my body and be like, So I really want my certification to back me up.
You know, I piggybacked sort of on to France, and I feel like I'm piggybacking here, but just, you always bring me outside of my comfort zone.
I mean, actually, speaking of France, I just read, I've been keeping all the updates, that soon they're opening up travel to Americans for the first time in over a year. But I told him already I wanted him to come here, so I don't know.
Things have been moving so quickly with the French man that I feel like the next obvious step is that we would see each other. Obviously, meeting someone in the flesh is completely different than talking, texting, even video chatting. And I have to remind myself that, like, even if we could meet, it could just be like no chemistry. Ugh, you know? So, ugh, it's so hard to think about that stuff. That's why you have to temper your expectations. It's our first morning on St. Simon's Island, and I am so happy to be, like, out of town, on vacation. I'm ready to jump into all of the planned activities, and plus, the Frenchman is calling soon, and we have a lot to talk about.
So what are you ladies looking forward to from this retreat?
I'm just happy to spend time with adults and relax.
My pandemic fatigue didn't come till now, like, till the last couple months, so I need some, like, energy to then go on and do some things I want to do.
Right.
What about you, Whitney?
You know, like, if you just feel like you're kind of like, your mind is here and your body is here and you just want to, like,
smush them
get together.
Yeah.
So I'd say that.
I hope you guys had a great breakfast.
We did.
Fantastic. And let's just go get ready for the day now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pop out. I'll be right back.
Okay, cool.
Thank you so much. Oh, for all of this is so lovely.
You're
Tell
welcome.
About how fast she's moving, who that is.
Hey, what's up? How you doing?
Hey. I really do want to be, like, super present on this retreat. So I hate to be one of those girls that's like, no, I had to talk to my man. But, like, yeah, I kind of just really wanted to talk to my French man. And now I feel much more settled. This house that we are in is absolutely insane. It's gorgeous. There's a chef. There's, like, a literal chef, like, in-house chef here, like, making all of our food and stuff. Like,
mac and cheese?
No, not yet, but I would kill for that. And it's just beautiful, it's warm, it's lovely. The only thing missing is you. I'll have to send you lots of pictures.
Oh yeah, feel free.
Basically, we're like one block from the ocean. I'm looking at it right now. I've never been here, because I mean, we have beaches in North Carolina, which you might enjoy a North Carolina beach. The good thing about North Carolina in general is we have mountains, we have beach, we have the foothills, we have me, you know?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'm having a hard time computing this.
Right.
Like, when I hear here in North Carolina, like, the whole tropical vibe doesn't strike me, you know, so that's why I'm like, oh.
I know that the Frenchman has never been to North Carolina, and I don't really know if he's super into nature, but in case he is, I am selling North Carolina for its mountains and its beaches. We have got peaks, we've got valleys, we have rolling hills, and of course, we have me. We're having an actual, like, photo shoot with a real photographer.
Is this something like a confidence build-up thing to photo shoot? I don't know.
Yeah, you know, just getting women together to, like, feel good about themselves and stuff like that. So, I don't know. I think we're going to get loose and just be wild for the first time in a year.
Yeah, well,
how wild can I get before you'll mind?
Well, you know, I don't own you, but, like,
But do you want to?
You know, I don't feel in the position to, you know, tell you what to do. You're a grown-ass woman. I mean, yeah, I don't know. It's just, I mean, you know.
Okay, I won't get wild. I'll wait for you before I get wild.
Oh, if we ever are able to travel again.
Listen, I just saw an article where they were saying that they're going to open France up to American tourists. maybe about a month, and then Americans can come. And I assume if Americans can come, that means that you could also come here.
No, really?
Yeah.
I haven't heard about that.
You don't sound...
Oh, you're teaching me something.
You don't sound excited. Oh, really? It's like your life just flashed before your eyes, like, oh, no, I didn't think about this day actually coming. Well, I can't say that I'm super pleased about the way this conversation is going. I was over the moon when I saw that the restrictions were about to relax. I was like, oh, thank the Lord Jesus. Now we can actually meet. And I can't say that he's matching my level of enthusiasm. I mean, I just want him to be as excited as I am.
Obviously, such trips need a bit of a...
planning.
Exactly. That's the word I was looking for. Thank you. You're so amazing with finishing my sentences. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Yeah. I mean, I'll look into it.
Okay. Cool. Look into it then. Well, thank you for calling. I missed you the last couple days.
Oh, really? Well, I mean, yeah, try also not, you know, to focus on that too much. And also maybe enjoying the trip.
How about you miss me too? I missed you too, but enjoy the trip. How about try that one? Can you please? I didn't expect this phone call to end with, like, him having booked flights or anything. But I also just, I'm not sure that we're necessarily on the same page in terms of meeting. And if he's not certain that, like, he wants to, like, meet me and be with me, well, I would be crushed. Yeah. Well, yeah, okay. Well, like I said, thanks for calling. And if you see anything about the restrictions lifting or anything, let me know. Because, yeah, obviously we would need to plan something, some way. Either way, whatever. But just, yeah, we'll just keep it on the radar, I guess.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, well, I'll send you pics and I'll talk to you later.
Okay, have a good one.
Okay, you too. Bye.
Bye.
I can feel that feeling creeping in of where I'm thinking, like, oh no, am I being an idiot? Oh no, like, what's going on? Like, I just wonder if there's something bad, really bad, that I don't know. I can feel myself going down this path, and I keep telling myself, Whitney, like, what are you doing? Stop. You don't know this person. This is not gonna work. He lives in France. Why are you even doing this? But then I just can't stop. I really can't. And I knew that you were gonna be there.
I'm just waiting on my coffee. Or my cafe au lait, should I say. Hello, are you here? Are you here with us? Are you?
I think so.
Oh my God, you're not here. I'm gonna give you time to come back down. Look at that.
I don't even know why. It's nothing. It was just a normal little, there's nothing to it.
But you are just seeing in Technicolor right now.
It just makes me want to be happy about it.
Well, I mean, what more could you ask for?
I asked him if I could get wild. And he was like, he basically gave me the, like, you're a grown woman and I respect your decisions and you do what you need to do.
So, like, you are at the point where you have to, like, talk about that with each other? It felt like you're there. You have arrived.
It's weird, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I guess I haven't been, like, too even thinking of it that much because I know, like, they're still on, like, a lockdown with a curfew. Like,
so I mean, maybe not for long.
I told him what
they're
the
not going to want to lose that tourist season. My.
I told him the article that you saw.
Yeah. Mm. Ooh, well, what did he, how did he?
He was fine. He just said, like, you know, well, obviously, like, a trip like that's going to include a lot of planning and blah, blah, blah. And I said, yeah. And I said, well, just keep it on your radar.
I kind of wanted his reaction to be like, yes, like, let's start looking, see if we can buy that ticket.
I know. I mean, agreed. Like, that would be nice. But I'm not surprised, like, the way he reacted, just because I know him. Like, it seemed normal, reaction.
And that's what I was going to say. For someone like us, like, that's not what Eric, my own boyfriend, would say to me. Like, for someone like us, it's probably a good idea to have someone just like.
Because I'll be on a plane tomorrow. Give me a baguette and a beret, and I'm on the plane.
Oh, you can get that when you get there.
Oh, God.
Ugh. I would go back to France. Look at me pre-inviting myself.
Well, I probably wouldn't want to go alone. I'd love for somebody to come with me.